I'm on the zone diet right now, which is, I've lost 12 pounds and I can't tell. I really think part of the zone diet is when they come to drop off your food, they somehow get in to your bathroom and tamper with the scale. Because it says I weigh less, and yet I don't feel like I weigh less. Because I am a total believer in the woozy diet, which I've discussed many, many times, which is I think you know a diet is working when you go to bed at night and you feel woozy and weak. That is the diet that works. Fuck this, oh, you have to eat every 3 hours. No, that makes you fat when you eat every 3 hours. You gotta eat once, you gotta have like a cracker and like some meat, and then you're done for the rest of the day, and you just drink Diet Coke. And that makes you lose weight. Honestly, so I'm on the zone diet, and it's really crazy. And this is, again, why I'm so sick of myself, really, right now, because of the state I'm in. So my friend gets me on the zone diet, and he says, you know, here's the thing. If you want something specific, you tell them you want it, and then they'll always bring it. You call them up, and you tell them you want it. So they have this cheesecake, right, which when you're on the zone diet, believe me, it is like it's a life preserver. It is the thing you wait for at the end of the day, that you can have that little wedge of cheesecake. And it's not even really cheesecake. I don't know what it is. If I ate a real piece of cheesecake as opposed to this, I like probably like stab somebody because I'd be so happy. But right now, that zone cheesecake seems real, and it becomes very important. So I call them up and I say, wow, this zone cheesecake, you know, I want the zone cheesecake every single day. And they go, okay, fine, yeah, zone cake, we'll do that. So it comes for like a day and or 2 days in a row. And then the third day, my food comes, which is, this is the other thing too. Just about the moment you're like ready to say, fuck this diet, I can't do this, then the new food comes. It's like an airdrop. Like the guy drives up and it's just outside your door and you're like, oh my God, here it is again. And I open it up and there's no cheesecake. I have a chicken meatball for my snack, which nobody wants a chicken meatball. Nobody wants a chicken meatball for a regular meal. They don't want it for a I don't even know what. I'm like, what do I do with it? Like, it's in a little container, like a little taller than like a Petri dish, and it's just like a chicken meatball and some kind of fucking low-fat cheese bullshit something on there, and it's not cheesecake is the point. So I call them up and I'm like, yeah, hi, it's John Riggi, and I called you a couple days ago and I said I want a cheesecake every day and I got the chicken meatball. And I don't want the chicken meatball, I want the cheesecake. And I want the cheesecake every day. And they're like, oh, we're sorry. It's just a mistake, you know, whatever, but it will take us a whole day to do it, but we'll get you the cheesecake. I'm like, okay, cool. So I eat the chicken meatball, you know, instead of the cheesecake, and it's terrible. And then the next night the food comes again, and I open it up, and it's another fucking chicken meatball. So you can't call them after like 7 o'clock, so I call them the next day, and I'm literally, this is the whole point of this, is I'm literally on the phone going, look, I want my cheesecake. I want my cheesecake. I called you twice. I said, I want my cheesecake. I don't want the chicken meatball. I want my cheesecake. And honestly, I was like, when I think about it now, if I had the chance, if I was taking that phone call, if that wasn't, I'd fucking kill me. I'm like a big fucking baby.